Good day, everyone, and welcome for Virtual Counter Calls live programs. Thank you for joining us today. Our channel, Virtual Counter Calls channel, is dedicated to bringing live performances and events from international artists to our dear audience, you, who are watching us from around the globe. I'm Anna Uspenskaya, I'm a pianist, and I'll be hosting today's program for you. Today we're presenting the second and final round of auditions for an opportunity for musicians to be selected to perform at the Whale Recital Carnegie Hall at the Gala. The Gala is going to happen in New York City at the Whale Recital Hall of Carnegie Hall on November 21 in New York. If you're in New York on that Thanksgiving week, please put us on our calendar and make sure to come to this concert. The Carnegie Hall auditions are organized by several organizations, Sound Dispressiva, Progressive Musicians, and Virtual Concert Halls. Okay, briefly, who are the organizers? The Sound Dispressiva Global Competition is an online, live-streamed competition. It combines the experience of a live performance and the virtual connection to all the audience members. Progressive Musicians is an organizer of many competitions and concerts at prestigious venues like Carnegie Hall. Virtual Concert Halls is an internet TV broadcasting company which is providing artists with a virtual stage and a virtual concert halls and ability to reach the audiences beyond the barriers and walls of conventional concert halls. So what are the Carnegie Hall auditions? The Carnegie Hall auditions are designed to give an opportunity for artists to apply and be selected for this concert. Throughout the audition process, musicians are connecting with the judges and have an opportunity to hear the comments from the judges immediately after the auditions in the first tier. The goal of these auditions is to encourage, to nurture, and reward musicians who are proactive about sharing their art and developing their careers. Sound Dispressiva and Progressive Musicians together are providing these opportunities for musicians to discover their unique artistic voice, to take initiative to present themselves on their own terms, to carve out, potentially in the future, their own career paths. Through these kinds of programs, we are inviting musicians to submit their pieces which represent them in the best way, in the way they want to see themselves on stage, in the way they want the audience to perceive their art.
Progressive Musicians and Sound Dispressiva is hosting live auditions for our Laureate Gala recital at Carnegie Hall this fall. Don't miss your opportunity to receive a professional video recording of your live performance on this world-renowned stage.
Thank you. about these auditions, people who applied for these opportunities from many, many countries are seeking guidance and support from the judges through live comments, which you were able to hear right after each performance during the first year of the auditions. Musicians took the judges' comments to their heart and worked very hard for 2 weeks on improving their pieces. So today is going to be a true preview of the gala concert, which is going to be presented on November 21st at the Carnegie Hall. Why? Because today you'll hear the actual pieces which auditionees intend to perform if they are selected. Here on the screen, you can see the date and pictures of the auditionees who applied for these auditions. We had an incredible crop of phenomenal musicians from around the entire world applying for this opportunity. So again, if you're in New York on Thanksgiving weekend, please make sure to put this concert on your calendar and go to the link below. Let's hope we can show you the link where you can reserve your tickets at the, right there. Here's the link where you can reserve your tickets. Keep in mind the concert hall, Carnegie Whale Recital Hall, is small. Reserve your seats today to make sure you can see the gala. And now I would like to invite on our virtual stage my colleague, pianist and conductor James Welch. Welcome, James, to the studio.
Thank you. Great to be back here and great to be involved with this with you.
Thank
you. It's been quite the fun process.
Yeah, very challenging for all of us on the back end of it, but it's extremely exciting. James is a pianist, conductor, and just yesterday he conducted an opening night of La Boheme in Fredonia, right?
Niagara Falls.
Niagara Falls.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Niagara Falls are not frozen yet, are they?
No, not yet. And it actually warmed up a little bit too, which was nice. So, but that didn't stop us from having it snow on stage. But that was planned. and it wasn't real snow. But, yeah.
Okay, I should hope so.
who knows what could happen up here, though.
That's right. James is the director of the Progressive Musicians, a co-sponsoring company of these auditions, and my dear colleague. And it's a great pleasure to be co-hosting with you today.
Likewise.
And now I would like to thank everyone who applied for these auditions, who went along with this, I would say, grueling process of preparing the first tier, then watching, then taking into account the comments which the judges were providing, and preparing for the second tier of auditions. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your encouragement. Thank you for your tremendous artistry. We're going to be presenting those videos in a minute. And I also would like to thank our audience and encourage all of you, please open the chat box on the channel, wherever you're watching us, on YouTube, on Facebook, on LinkedIn, on Vimeo, on Twitch, on Twitter. We're everywhere. Please open the chat box and give us your comments, give us your support, give musicians this incredible feel of connection with your audience. And last but not the least, thanks go to the incredible Virtual Concert Halls team, people who prepare and run these broadcasts. It's a very complicated process, and I'm tremendously proud to thank Fran Irusinovich, who is the director of this show today, and Fedor Ospensky, who is a technical assistant for this show today. And we'll have more programs at noon, at 6, and then at 10 p.m., the announcement of winners of these auditions will come. So thank you all very much. And with no further ado, I would like to start presenting our musicians. We will be starting with the age group 5 to 7. And James, why don't you introduce our first auditionee?
Sure. Where are we here on this list? Here we are. So the 5 to 7 division, our first musician is Lutea Guo.
My name is Astrid. I'm 6 years old. I have been playing piano for 2 years. My favorite fruit is strawberry. I also like rock climbing and drawing.
Wow, Litau, thank you so much for this very cute introduction and beautiful, beautiful melodious playing. I'm really impressed how such a young person like you can make the line so warm and sinking. And that teddy bear was just darling. Thank you very much. We'll be inviting on stage our next performer in the age group 5 to 7, and that'll be Michael Kim.
Hello, my name is Michael Kim. I enjoy playing the violin. I enjoy
enjoy when I can play my songs well. I am learning to play Stax Concerto in D major and Beret by Bach. Today I will play Beret for you. Thank you for watching and listening.
Oh, that was so sweet. And welcome, James, back to our studio. I loved this playing. It's so uplifting and so beautiful. And maybe Michael can even start doing vibrato sometime soon. I mean, I leave it up to his teacher. He has a phenomenal teacher, obviously. Okay. So we will be inviting on stage the next auditionee. And it's we are in the 5 to 7 age group, let's not forget, these are extraordinary young musicians presenting those complex pieces for us. Let's welcome Vincent Young.
My name is Vincent and I am 7 years old. I live with my mom and dad in California. I started playing piano when I was 4. My favorite composer is Beethoven. I also like hockey and art. I like hockey because I like skating fast. I like art because I can express my feelings in it. I hope you like my music.
So Vincent announced to us that Beethoven is his favorite composer, and it sounded like a lot of polish and a lot of love to that rondo. Wonderful job. I loved listening to that.
Indeed. Yeah, it was just wonderful.
Okay, we're moving on to the age group 8 to 10. Those are going to be old people, don't you think, James? Compared to the 5 to 7.
Sure.
Yes. Yeah. Gosh, it makes me feel ancient.
I mean, not as old as us, though. I'm only 15. So.
Exactly. So the next age group is ages 8 to 10. And we'll start with Amelia Xu, who applied for the concerto division for an opportunity to be selected to perform with the New York Chamber Players Orchestra, directed by Maestro Giacomo Franchi. So welcome on virtual stage, Amelia Xu. Thank you. I enjoyed it so much, and it's such an elegant phrasing she has in there, don't you think, James?
Oh yes, definitely. You know, very, very pleasant, very well worked out. It's you know, a lot of people don't realize just how difficult it is to memorize something like that, and you know, at such a young age too. I mean, that's really wonderful.
There's so many repeats in that movement where you can just shift in the wrong direction, and Amelia did not. That's incredible.
Yeah. And such a great dress too.
Yes.
Yeah.
So nice. Yeah, stage is also visual, so it's really good to see that our young artists take that seriously and present themselves as a whole, not just okay, I can play well, but what about being pleasant to look at? This is wonderful.
Indeed.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you. We'll be inviting on stage our next auditionee for this for the gala at the Carnegie Hall. This will be age group 8 to 10, just reminding everyone. And the solo division will be inviting on stage Amber Nyeon Kim. The stage is all yours.
My name is Amber Nyeon Kim. I'm very happy to be here auditioning for you today. I'd like to thank all the judges for their feedback from the first tier auditions. I've been working very hard to improve my violin playing, and I will be playing Vivaldi Concerto in A minor first movement. Thank you for this opportunity. I hope you enjoy.
Oh, wow. This is one of the most incredible eye-popping improvement I've heard, at least so far, for this, between the first-tier auditions and the second-tier auditions. This is pretty amazing how much more polish and musicality and technical fluency a young person like Amber can demonstrate in just a short 2 weeks. Amber, please hold on to that kind of practicing you did in those 2 weeks, because it's going to take you very far.
Yeah, indeed. And I mean, it's one of the biggest things that we were hoping to help people achieve when we first started these things with progressive musicians, is that, well, let's give them some feedback and let's see what they can do in just a couple of weeks. And it's the turnaround rate among everyone has just, you know, been very, very noticeable. And in all of our events. And it's just so great to see.
And what I found also very encouraging is people discover really how much more potential they have when they're given a short time to improve, and they really hone on to what was suggested for them to work on. I'm sure the auditionees will watch their own performances in the 2 weeks span, and they will discover quite a bit more of their own potential, and that's part of the purpose of doing the auditions this way. Indeed. Sometimes we have the self-limiting view of ourselves. Well, I can do this much in a week or 2 weeks, but no, we can do a lot more than that.
Well, and even my teacher in college would say, you have to set records. You have to keep records. And this was before everything was on video like it was, you know, because, I mean, this was just 2 years ago. But he would take out his notebook, somewhere around midterm or the end of the semester. And, you know, if I was a little upset that I wasn't doing well, or that I just wasn't making it through a phrase or something like that, you know, he'd take out his notebook and show me, look at where you were last month. You were playing your scales at this speed. You only had half of the piece learned. It wasn't memorized. You know, and then a month later, you know, your scales are way faster. You have two pieces memorized or something like that. And it was always reassuring because, I mean, like, I would have never thought to really keep track of that many details. And it's so much easier with the video now. Just go back and listen. You know, this was 2 weeks ago. What was I doing? You know, this one's much better now. You know, but yeah.
Yeah, exactly. All right. Well, thank you, Amber, for demonstrating everyone what can be done by such a young musician as yourself in just a short 2 weeks. We're ready to move on to the next person, right, James?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Yep, let's do it. And the next person is has applied for two different opportunities. One to perform a concerto at the Carnegie Hall Gala Concert on November 21st. And another opportunity to perform a solo. Let's welcome on stage Aria Zhao.
Thank you.
Just beautiful. Wow. And what a nice hall and piano and orchestra that you got to play this with already. Such a wonderful experience, and you know, just beautiful playing. And you know, just love the enthusiasm and drive that you bring to that. It's just, you know, great to listen to. Really wonderful. Bravo. Okay, moving on. We are still in our 8 to 10 age division, and we now have a guitarist, Catalina Wirt. Welcome to the virtual stage.
Thank you.
Bravo. Bravo. Nice to have guitar in here. And again, just nice to hear all the improvements that everybody has made in a very short amount of time. It's not as easy as one would think to do that. Hours and hours of practice every day to make improvements like that. So, bravo. Keep up the good work, everybody. Okay, moving along, we are still in the 8 to 10 division, and our next musician is auditioning for concerto and for a solo slot on the Laureate Gala. Welcome, Kate Lee, to the virtual stage.
Hello, I am Kate Lee. Today I will play Polonaise Concerto in A minor.
Thank you.
Program presented right it there, is. Kate. And you're so young. This is unbelievable. A young person can carry out such a complex and long program. And I wanted to also point out what a wonderful accompanist you got, Kate. Right on with you. Blended for me like one full piano playing. Don't you think, James?
Indeed. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. It's, you know, it's one thing to find a really great pianist, but it's another thing to find someone that you can collaborate with really well and be supportive of the soloist. And you know, that's just not all great pianists can do both as easily as Franny did there.
Yeah, but, thank you, Franny, for your wonderful accompaniment. That was great job. And just for the people who are watching us, and we talk about Franny. Franny Rusinovich is the director of this program today, and Fyodor Uspensky is assisting. Thank you, wonderful team, for your support. These are musicians who learned this art of presenting live programs in addition to being fantastic artists. So we're very grateful for the pandemic time, which allowed musicians to think outside the box and to look for other venues where they can apply their multifaceted talents. Wonderful. Thank you. We're ready to move on to the next person. And let's welcome on virtual stage an auditionee for both concerto and solo, Lucia Tang. The virtual stage is all yours. Okay, we will present Lucia Tang's performance in just a few short minutes. We just changed the order a little bit to accommodate for this particular performance to be presented with both picture and audio. We'll be inviting on virtual stage the contestant in the solo division. This is age group 8 to 10. I'm reminding again everyone who is watching. And the virtual stage now belongs to Pin Jen Chen vocals. What an artistic presence on stage. I loved that bow at the end of your performance. Pinjan, beautiful angelic voice. Not only you're developing a real presence on stage. That's really wonderful to observe. Thank you for presenting this. We will invite on stage the next auditionee. We're in the age 8 to 10, and this will be a violinist who applied for an opportunity to perform solo at the Carnegie Laureates Gala concert on November 21st in New York City. The virtual stage will be now, we'll invite now Ryan Zhang. Ryan, it's all yours. Welcome. Thank you. Beautiful playing. Thank you, Ryan. And thank you for all the improvements you made in your playing. This is wonderful to observe. This is a difficult concerto for professionals even. It's just so demanding for good sound and intonation and also phrasing. And it's some of the hardest classical versions of classical pieces. There's some which are less unforgiving than this one. This one is really unforgiving, and you're doing a fantastic job. You're so in command of it. Thank you. We'll be inviting on stage the next musician, and it's a pianist. We are in the eight to 10 group still. Sophia Zhang applied for a solo, for an opportunity to perform solo at the Carnegie Hall on November 21st in the Laureates Gala. Welcome on virtual stage, Sophia Zhang.
Hello, my name is Sophia Zhang. I'm 8 years old and I am a third grader at Clagren Elementary School. I have an older brother, his name is Luke. He's 13. He also plays piano. I live with my mom and dad in Edmond, Oklahoma, United States. I have been learning piano since I was 5 and a half. My piano teacher is Rere Johnson. She is very good at piano, and she is very kind to me, and I love her. I love piano because I can express my feelings when I play the piano. I love to perform the pieces with beautiful melodies and rhythms. It brings me joy and happiness. Besides piano, I am very good as a swimmer and I love singing and ballet too. I love reading. My favorite one is Diary of a Wimpy Kid. I love to play with my friends. I hope you all will enjoy my piano performance today. I've practiced this week in accordance with the comments which the judges gave to me from the first edition. Thank you.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Wonderful, Sophia. This is really wonderful to hear how much she loves to do. She loves to do this and that, and piano is part of it, and she plays with so much joy and energy. And she even commented, I practiced according to what the judges suggested for me to do. And that's the way to go. Judges were giving the best to comment so you can grow based on those comments.
Yeah, okay, just wonderful. So, who do we have next here? We
have a vocal auditionee in the age group 8 to 10. Who is applying for solo performance for an opportunity to perform solo at the Carnegie Hall in November, and we'll be inviting on stage the singer Yung Soan Lee. Virtual stage is all yours.
Welcome.
Love that presentation. Already like a stage star. Singing and dancing. I can't do either. She's doing them both together.
She brought the whole package to that one.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you, Yung San, for this wonderful presentation and the costume. And she's playing with a prop in there. My goodness, what an artist.
Definitely. Yeah. Wonderful.
Okay, are we ready to move on to the next person?
Yes, I think so. Who do we have up next? My list keeps getting buried here. we have Zakaya Andy Wong, who's auditioning for Concerto.
So welcome on virtual stage, Zakaya Andy Wang. It's all yours.
Hi, my name is Andy. I come from Canada. I have been learning piano for 3 years with Dr. Olga Chichova. I like my teacher very much. I like Mozart music. Today I'll perform Concerto in A major by Mozart. I have practiced it very hard. Hope you enjoy it.
Bravo, bravo, bravo.
Bravo.
What an elegant performance. And indeed. I wanted again to point out that is quite an ensemble, quite a connection and really, really good rapport you have with your very supportive accompanist.
Indeed.
I'm assuming that must be his teacher. Yeah.
This
beautiful
is
playing.
Great teacher, great pianist.
Yeah, great teacher, great pianist, and great student. What a joy. Now we'll be inviting on virtual stage Lucia Tang, who applied to perform a concerto or solo in the upcoming Laureate's Gala concert in New York City at the Carnegie Whale Recital Hall. The virtual stage is all yours, Lucia Tang. Welcome.
Thank you.
a huge improvement. You see, you mean stunning since the first year.
Yes. Yeah. I keep saying this over and over throughout all of these auditions, but it really is amazing to see the improvement that everybody makes in a short amount of time. But, you know, additionally, like, even like our previous participants from other events too, just over, we've all been at this like, what, 2 years, 3 years, 2 years, you know, and there's just been so much growth across the board. I know Progressive Musicians has had, I think this is our fifth, maybe our sixth, I don't know anymore, time flies, but we've had a few people involved in everything all the way through, or, you know, maybe someone who just skipped one, and they come back, and it's like, who are you? What have you done? Yeah, I mean, you've worked so hard. Like, it's just, you know, it's just amazing to see that. It's also refreshing to just see the enthusiasm behind all of the preparation and all that, because, I mean, it's really, it's one thing to go to a concert and watch it, or to come turn on your computer and watch someone perform, but it's another thing to prepare, and it really takes a lot of work and a lot of time and dedication and a lot of tough life choices sometimes too. I mean, you have all of your friends or family getting together for something, and it's like, no, sorry, I have to practice, and it really takes a lot of discipline that way, and in some ways, some cases, sacrifice too. And it really shows how much of that is happening and how much everybody really loves what they're doing to make this kind of progress in what is a year is still a short amount of time.
Absolutely. And it's so rewarding to see people take the most out of this kind of programming, because that's exactly what we are here to support. Not necessarily, well, we celebrate today's accomplishments, that's for sure. And we reward musicians for this kind of dedication, love, work, and developing their talent with an opportunity to perform in the Carnegie Hall. But in a more long run perspective, we are supporting exactly this, the dedication to self-growth, to growing as artists, as presenters, as musicians, as communicators. And this is extremely rewarding to see how young musicians and teachers and judges and everyone is taking this opportunity to really promote the journey through music, the journey through the growth. And that's just wonderful. Thank you all for being such an active part of this process.
Definitely. And we must extend a thank you to all the accompanists too. I mean, especially that last one. That one was great. I don't know who that was.
Let's just leave it out there for guessing.
I mean, there's. Yeah, I mean, sometimes these accompanists, you know, for events like this, end up playing for like 20 people. Sometimes. I mean, I don't think we're seeing that here, but I mean, who knows? I mean, you know, a lot of these videos, you can't see the accompanist, or it was a recorded track that an accompanist recorded. You know, I mean, but I mean, there's a lot that goes into that, and that needs to be recognized. And so thank you to all the collaborative pianists out there.
Yeah, I definitely want to thank all collaborative pianists. Your input is invaluable, because as I'm a teacher myself as well. So as a teacher, we prepare the students for performance, and then someone else has to take that product, that preparation, on to the next stage. Very often, we invite another musician to work with our students to prepare for the recording or performance of a collaborative composition, and that opens another opportunity for growth. And it's so wonderful to see our colleagues supporting this process and really, really working with the students and working on their own parts. I mean, some of those accompaniments you have to learn and practice even as a professional. They're not easy pieces.
No.
So, yeah, I want to.
And they're not written for the piano.
And they're not. No, they're reductions from the orchestra, finger-breaking versions of it.
So, you know, I mean, sometimes it looks like we have to play 15 notes all at the same time.
That's right. They just take the full score and fingers. Dump it on the pianist. Go, do
just
it.
Just use our forearm. Yeah. But yeah.
Exactly. And so exquisitely prepared. I want to thank all the collaborative pianists for this kind of really exquisite preparation and work. Okay, I think we're ready to take a quick pause and to explain to those who are joining us at this moment what is it we're doing today. And we are in the middle of the long process. We want to share with you a little bit about the auditions and the upcoming concerts. And then after that, we'll be moving on to the next contestants in and the next age group, which will be 11 to 14. So stay tuned. And with a little, this little pause, I would like to introduce the concept of those auditions. So we are auditioning musicians who applied for an opportunity to perform at the Carnegie Whale Recital Hall on November 21st at 8 p.m. in New York City. That's Thanksgiving weekend. If you happen to be in New York, please put
the
date and the time.
Just a few days before.
Yeah, it's just a few days before Thanksgiving. It's that holiday week.
Yeah. So 1 month from yesterday.
Exactly. Yeah, very short 1 month. Put that date on your calendar and please go to the Carnegie Hall calendar and the Carnegie Hall website to reserve your seats. The hall is not huge, it's pretty sizable, but if you want to see those uprising stars in the live performance at the Carnegie Hall, you need to really go to the website and get your tickets now, because they're going fast. So as you can see, the concert will be on November 21st, 2022, and it'll present at the concert, we will present soloists, small and large ensembles, and soloists who perform concerti with New York Chamber Players Orchestra, conducted by Maestro Giacomo Franchi. You can see the picture of the orchestra and the maestro on your left, and pictures of the auditionees on your right. And today we are presenting a real truly preview of that concert, because all of the pieces you're hearing today are the choices of the contestants of the repertoire which they will present at the concert on October 21st if they are selected for that concert. Now, the auditions today are all day live streaming. We have four sessions. We're in our first session, which started at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and we'll go for another hour, I want to say. The next session at noon Eastern Standard Time will start with a group, age group of 15 to 18, and will end with adult amateur contestants. And throughout the entire day, we will be presenting both, all different categories of repertoire, solo, small ensembles, large ensembles, and concerti. In the first year of auditions, we had a special session dedicated to concerti, which was judged by pianists and string judges and wind instrument judges and the conductor of the New York Chamber Players Orchestra. In the second year of auditions, concertos are going to be presented throughout the whole day. We are ready to also tell you a little bit about our upcoming auditions. Together with Progressive Musicians and Brilliant Talent Discovery Awards and Core Production, Virtual Concert Halls, Sandus Perceiver, these all companies and organizations put together our efforts and our resources to sponsor another auditions coming up. The deadline for those auditions is November 1st. Please consider applying for call orchestra auditions. These are auditioning only soloists who intend to perform either concertos or arias or other pieces, concert pieces, for the solo instrument or solo voice with accompanying orchestra. Now, the orchestra which we have participating in this project, Western Chamber Western New York Chamber Orchestra has two concerts dedicated to the winners of these auditions on February 17th and 19th in Fredonia and Buffalo in upstate New York. The winners of these auditions will be presented in the third of the Masterworks series of the Western New York Chamber Orchestra. This is an incredible opportunity for musicians to perform with a professional orchestra in professional series concerts, and to have those concerts live streamed, and to have the recording of that concert be part of their future portfolio. As musicians, we all need very much to have an experience to grow our skills and to build our portfolio, so that when we apply for another opportunity to perform and people ask us, well, can you really play? We say, sure, there, I just performed with Western New York Chamber Orchestra. So please consider applying for these editions. We are inviting pianists, string players, wind players, and vocalists of all voice ranges. Sample repertoire list is on our websites. There's several organizations participating in this project, so you can go to any one of those websites: Sound Perceiver, Progressive Musicians, Brilliant Talent Discovery Awards, or Core Production. On all of those websites, you can click on the sample of the repertoire list and see if any of those concertos are at your fingertips, and if not, and you're working on some other concerto concert piece or newly written work, all of those repertoires are accepted for consideration. Please get in touch with us. Send us your choices, the pieces which you would like to present, and make sure to get your repertoire pre-approved if it is not on the sample list. Now remember, this is just a sample list. There's absolutely no way someone can put an exhaustive, complete list of all concerti and all arias which can be accepted by a professional chamber orchestra. And we are not even trying to pretend that we know them all. You do. So send us your choice of the repertoire for our consideration. Make sure it's pre-approved before you apply.
Might I add, for the first tier of auditions, it's a complete free choice of repertoire. Does not have to be a concerto. You can send a video of your very best performance from whenever, just to get you through the first round and be considered for the second round, which is live, where you play the concerto in the second round a month later.
Yes, and so you have that month to polish and prepare for the live audition with your concerto, and live will be on the live public broadcast, just like this one, where you will be performing live from your own location, and you will be presenting your piece in front of the panel of judges from different instruments and different voice ranges, and also the conductors. So you are auditioning with the conductors, and you will hear the immediate comments from the judges suggesting improvements, suggesting whatever they want to suggest, and you will get the opportunity to chat with them also on the broadcast, ask them questions, and find out how your performance looks like and feels from the conductor's perspective, which I find extremely helpful for my
indeed there are not any other competitions or auditions that I know of where you get to interact with the judges. I mean, I've done so many of these live all around the world, and it's like you have to wait outside the door at midnight and hope that they come out the front door and, you know, just track them down for a second. Please tell me something. And, you know, and if they remember you know, from the day from like 12 hours ago, I mean, then you're lucky.
But exactly. On these auditions, you don't need to worry about the judges and conductors forgetting something and not sharing with you their immediate thoughts, because we put them on the hot plate and we ask them to share with you what they think immediately right after your performance. So,
yeah. And you don't even have to leave your house.
Exactly. You don't have to spend enormous amount of money on traveling and take off your work or study. You can be part of this audition process from the comfort of your own home or the studio or wherever you're comfortable to perform. Okay, I think we're ready. James, are we ready to move on to the next age group?
Yeah, let's do this.
Yeah, let's do this. It's ages 11 to 14, and I'll let you introduce our first performer.
Our first performer is auditioning for concerto and for a solo spot on the recital, and it is Annabelle Wee, violinist. Welcome to the virtual stage, Annabelle.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. That's one of my absolute favorite concertos. Bravo. It's so hard to play slow movement. It takes a lot of dedication to every sound in there.
Mine too.
Yeah.
That second movement's one of my favorite from, I think, the entire Four Seasons.
Mm-hmm. And Annabelle really puts her heart into every sound of that movement.
Indeed. Yeah. You can totally see how much she really loves playing it.
Yep. Thank you for a beautiful presentation, Annabelle. And I just want to mention that at the Carnegie Hall Laureates Gala, we're going to have a very honorable guest speaking for us. And he just joined in and commented. Here is good luck to all at Carnegie from Steve Robinson.
That's amazing. He's watching.
He's watching. Hi, Steve. Thank you very much for tuning in. Steve Robinson is a radio producer and host of many programs and worked in many radio stations across the country for many years. He is a co-producer of... now I forget the name of that radio program. Music Conversations with Bill McLaughlin. And I'm sorry if I'm saying it wrong. It's been on the tip of my tongue and just left me for a moment.
Did you say he's in Boston now?
He's in Boston, and he'll be traveling to New York in November to be part of the presentation of the gala at the Carnegie Hall. He'll be speaking to everyone from the stage, and it's a great honor and pleasure to have Steve join us.
That's wonderful. Really looking forward to it.
Yep. And we're ready for the next performer. Let me welcome on stage violinist in the age group 11 to 14 who applied for an opportunity to perform a concerto or solo, Luisa Maria Cordes. Welcome on virtual stage. It's all yours.
Hello, my name is Luisa Marie Cordes. I turned 12 last week and I live in Kiel, that's in Germany. I play the violin for 6 years and I love to perform as a soloist. But I also like to be a part of an orchestra. My hobbies are playing the violin, taekwondo and skiing.
Thank you.
Thank you, Luisa Maria. James, do you remember if someone among judges said something that her style is so suitable for Mozart, or am I confused?
Yeah, it
something?
Was Giacomo, the conductor from New York Chamber Players, and I remember after she had played the Wieniawski, he said, "No, I think you have a style for Mozart, and I would love to hear Mozart." And here she is playing Mozart so beautifully.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, he called that one right on the money, and it's obviously...
And it's like that. He
worked hard. Yeah.
She pulls the Mozart. Okay, maestro, you want to hear Mozart? Here it is. That's a real artist. Oh, wow. Bravo.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah. It's... I mean, it's never always a reality when a judge says, well, I would like to hear this, that someone says, well, I have that. Here you go. You know, and, you know, I mean, it's more of like the dream. It's like, well, you know, I go into these live theater auditions once in a while, and we hear them sing for like a minute, maybe two, if, you know, it's a slow day. And we say once in a while, you know, I really would like to hear you sing something like this. And usually, maybe like 8 times out of 10, they're like, well, I have something close to that. And then, okay, well, let's hear you sing it. Almost never do they have exactly what it is. But, you know, once in a while, it's like, I have this. Want to hear it? I'm like, sure, go ahead. You know, and so, I mean, I feel like that's kind of what happened here.
Exactly.
I mean, you know, I mean, we're talking about 2-minute excerpts in the auditions that I'm referring to.
Right, and you're
but
talking
like,
about
I mean,
professional
you know,
auditions.
In 2 weeks, she's like, okay, well, here's a whole movement of a Mozart concerto. I mean, it's kind of the same thing there. I mean,
right, and you're talking about professionals auditioning for casting in the roles
true.
In opera.
True, college students and professionals. Yeah, I mean, not kids.
Right, let's not forget, she's a kid in the age group of 11 to 14.
It makes it all the... bigger deal. I'm a loss for vocabulary here, but
this is wonderful.
I think we get what I'm trying to say here.
Yeah, that's definitely highlight for me too. To hear, okay, here's the composer you requested, and it's a whole concerto of it. Wonderful. Okay, bravo. We're ready to move on to our next auditionee in the age group of 11 to 14, a violinist. Welcome on stage, Luisa Valentina Shuey. The virtual stage is all yours.
Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you.
Bravo.
Bravo, bravo, bravo. It's such a long piece. It's so hard to sustain the quality which you put into the beginning all throughout the piece for professionals too. I heard too many wonderful beginnings of that movement and
I was thinking the same thing, and you know, and even after that movement's done, I mean, there's still like another 15 minutes of it, you know.
Exactly.
I mean, it was that long lyrical second movement, which is like some of the most beautiful C major I've ever heard, and then,
C major is one of the most unforgiving keys for violin.
Yeah. Well, and in some ways, piano too. I mean, you think playing all white keys is easy. There's like really nothing to latch onto.
Exactly. One little twitch of the fingertip and you're in a completely different world.
The fun part about that is then, you know, from C major, it goes to E major and ends in E major. The concerto in E minor, you know, ends on a really fun, spirited journey, it turns out. But
that concerto is a masterpiece, and she did a great job with it for a person
of course,
so young. This is
indeed
wonderful.
Yeah, it's beautiful playing.
Fantastic potential.
We need to praise all the pianists.
She has a fabulous pianist too. Thank you so much for the work your collaborative pianist put into this.
That's not an easy one to play. I mean, there's a lot of notes that have to be left out and then making cuts and all that. And I mean, she handled that beautifully. So
it's a difficult accompaniment. Yeah. Mm-hmm. it's an all around challenging piece for the soloist orchestra, for the orchestra too, and for the pianist who takes the orchestral part and puts it into this piano version of it. Yep.
And you kind of have to be the conductor in some ways.
You as a conductor, you know exactly what this means, pulling it together. Yep. I also wanted to mention that for these auditions, we're taking a step away from more conventional approach, where most competitions only will hear portion of the program which contestants prepare. And in the auditions, as James mentioned in the previous transition, when we were talking, a lot of times professionals only get like a minute or two on stage, so it's just an excerpt. So this in a way, of course, saves time, and there's lots of reasons for the auditions and competitions to be held that way, but there is a disadvantage in there. When we have an opportunity to present the piece in a whole, we are presenting other aspects of our artistry which cannot be really communicated through a short, small excerpt of the performance. The sense of form, sense of development, our own take on the story behind the piece. It's really very disappointing to see that, okay, well, we're auditioning for an opportunity to play a big piece on stage, and we only get to play a tiny bit of it. Also, I've noticed with my students and many even colleagues, it kind of discourages people from putting the entire effort into the whole composition, into the whole picture of it, because a lot of times we know we're not going to be heard. So I want to communicate this to the young musicians and to the teachers. Let's just not bend to this trend, and let's make sure we teach our students to take the entire composition as a whole, as a full picture with all the fringe and parts of it which may not be all presented in the exposition of it. So I think that does more justice to those masterpieces composed by the wonderful musicians of our past.
Indeed.
So, okay, James, we're ready to move on to the next person?
Yes, we are. Who do we have here? We have Luke Eggert, and we're still in the 11 to 14 division here. Luke Eggert, a violinist auditioning for solo. Welcome to the virtual stage.
Hello, everyone. My My name is Luke Eggert. I live in Killeen, Texas, near Fort Hood, where my dad retired from the Army. When I was 4 years old, I started my musical journey through the Suzuki violin method with Mrs. Jennifer. Ever since then, I have loved playing the violin because it allows me to express my feelings through music. I get excited when I have the opportunity to learn different styles of music, like pop, jazz, and fiddle playing, because they expand my versatility as a performer. I'm also a member of the first violin section for Waco Youth Orchestra this season. I have been fortunate to have had master classes and lessons with some of the most incredible violinists over the years, such as William Hagen, Brian Lewis, Amy Beth Horman, Hal Grossman, Elizabeth Bailey, and Caroline Campbell. When I'm not studying for school or practicing my violin, I like to play chess, ukulele, video games, and create drawings. I also enjoy training and competing in fencing tournaments.
Thank you.
that's a wonderful performance. Every violinist plays this piece, and it's so, I want to say, so thin. It's so difficult to keep the quality of the sound and all those fast notes in there and intonation. Oh my God, look, you did a fantastic job.
Yes, and indeed. And yeah, it's nice to hear kind of like an original spin on it too. It's really easy to just kind of mimic the recordings that you hear, and it's really, I don't think that was the case in Luke's performance. So
yeah, yeah, very polished, very mature.
Yeah,
wonderful bow control, and with a sound rounded and beautiful.
Bravo.
Bravo, bravo. Okay, we're ready to move to the next auditionee in the age group of 11 to 14. And the pianist applied to perform in both categories a concerto with the New York Chamber Players Orchestra under the baton of Maestro Giacomo Franchi, and or a solo, depending on how the judges will be doing the selection. We will be welcoming on virtual stage Matthew Brandt. Stage is all yours.
Welcome.
Thank you.
you. Okay, I have a question, and I hope Matthew will answer that question. Who wrote the cadenza? Okay.
He's not here.
We'll probably get a comment at one point.
Yeah.
And I have my own suspicions, which I want confirmed and disproved. And I'll spit it out. I suspect Matthew composed it himself.
Me too. Yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, he's written so many wonderful pieces that we've heard in previous events that, you know, I mean, the pieces that I'd like to buy when they're published. I mean, yeah,
exactly. And you're not the only one who's saying that. Some other judges were saying, Matthew, please publish your pieces. I want to teach them to my students because mm-hmm. they're fabulous. He has such a fresh look on things. Mm-hmm. I love that slow version of the main theme. That is really, really cool.
Yeah. And there's so many different cadenzi for these concerti. But I've definitely never heard that one and really liked it.
I really liked it very much, and the playing is so fluent and fluid, and it's great joy to hear you, Matthew. Thank you.
Likewise, yes.
We'll be moving on to the next performer, pianist, in the age group of 11 to 14, who applied for the opportunity to perform a solo piece at the Laureate's Gala at Carnegie Whale Recital Hall on November 21st. Let's welcome on stage Richard Long. Virtual stage is all yours. Welcome, Richard.
Hello, my name is Richard Long. I'm 11 years old and I'm from Toronto, Canada. I recently passed level 10 RCM and I study music with my teacher, Olga Chichova. I won first place in Kiwanis Festival in Guelph, and I got an honorable mention from the provincial nominee. I like jazz music, and I have my own band. Thank you. That took me on a ride. Wonderful. This kid has his own band. That shows.
He does. Yeah. We don't get to hear Bolcom too often, a solo piano.
Yeah.
I mean, and there's works that exist, but you just don't hear it played
very much, and I mean, yeah, the way he wrote some excellent stuff.
Yeah, and the way Richard played that piece makes me want to learn it. Thank you,
me
Richard.
Too. Yeah, that's really. Oh yeah, it just makes me want to dance in my seat.
Boom. Yeah. Such an energetic, powerful feeling. Wonderful. Great. We are moving on to the last performer in the morning session. Right, James?
Wow. Yeah. Man, this really went by fast. Yeah.
Yeah, indeed.
Yeah. Last performer and another guitar.
Let's welcome on stage Sonia Wert, a guitarist in the age group of 11 to 14, and she applied for an opportunity to perform a solo piece at the Laureate's Gala at the Carnegie Hall on November 21st. Sonia, virtual stage is all yours. Welcome.
Welcome. Thank you.
Bravo.
Bravo.
What a wonderful way to finish our morning session with this, almost like a tribute to music.
A tribute to me. I love it. Yeah. Tribute to music and musicians and just music around the world too. It's not always evident as to where each of these performers are now with remote. Someone could be on the moon and we might not know it. Maybe the oxygen tank would give them away, but who knows? I mean, the way we're going, we might have the Lunar Symphony someday. Yeah, you know, soon.
We just need to ask Elon Musk to sponsor a trip up there and build a country hall.
Sponsored by Tesla. Yeah.
Sponsored by Tesla. Yeah. Let's send a petition.
We'll get on that. Next week. Yeah.
Next week. That's
when
right.
We're not so
after
busy.
After we finish these auditions. Yeah. And Sonia, thank you so much for bringing this piece. I love this piece, and your feel of the dancey element in there was really contagious. Wonderful playing.
Yeah, it's really nice to hear it on a guitar too.
Exactly.
Yeah, I've played that piece on piano more times than I can count, and it's really
just really
a neat
brought
piece,
the...
but with guitar, I mean.
Yeah, she brought that flavor of the guitar, what guitar can add to that. We always strive on the piano to imitate other instruments, but this flavor of the guitar is really special. And she
a whole new life.
Well. Yep.
Yeah.
Wonderful work.
Bravo.
Bravo. We'll be finishing this session, but before we say goodbye for a very short time, I would like to thank everyone who is a part of these auditions. Many thanks go to our panel of judges. You can see the community of international artists who join our auditions for judging and helping with the commenting for young musicians and professionals and everyone who seeks the input and some encouragement and help with the study and growth. On the website at soundesperceiver.com, please go there and open the judges' profiles, learn about who they are, where they are, what they do, and what they can bring, how they can enrich your own musical journey. And I want to thank the organizers of those auditions, and many thanks go to you, James, and Progressive Musicians. Thank you very much for expanding our ability to present musicians with these opportunities and now at the Carnegie Whale Recital Hall. And thank you very much for all the hard work you put into these auditions.
Well, you're welcome. And thank you to you and Sound Espressivo for all of the work that you put into this as well. And you know, to all of your team at virtual concert halls and
and a big shout out goes to the virtual concert halls team. I want to stress the point that everyone on this team are musicians. So we formed this group of incredible artists who are able to also produce these shows to the highest quality and all the coordination. And today our director of the show is pianist Frane Rusinovic, and he is directing our entire program from Croatia. And assisting him today is Fedor Uspensky. So these two people, Fedor Uspensky is a violinist, he's a Juilliard-trained violinist, assisting from Maryland. So thank you everyone on that list. We'll see Chris Aoko hosting with us next session, and all the visuals and graphic designers, all these people are musicians and with multifaceted talents, dedicating their work and their love to presenting these programs and to helping musicians step on stages, both virtual and physical stages in the concert halls. And I also want to thank our audience for joining us, for sending us your comments. Please don't forget, the chat box is open. Please comment, please send us questions. And if you like our programming, please subscribe to our channels. We go live online quite often, and we would like to reach you when we do go online and we are live on the broadcast. Thank you all for joining us for the first session of the all-day broadcast of the second tier and the final tier of the Carnegie Gala laureates auditioning. These are musicians auditioning for the opportunity to play solos, small ensembles, large ensembles, and concerti and arias with New York Chamber Players Orchestra under the baton of Maestro Giacomo Franchi. James, did I forget anything?
We mentioned that we're back on at noon in 50 That's minutes, right? Yeah. Yep. Yep. We're back on in 50 minutes with the ages 15 to 18 and the adult amateurs. So
that's right. If you're busy at that time, don't worry. We have another session prepared for you. Join us at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and that will be for collegiate division college students and professionals. And then, drum roll, at 10 p.m., we will be announcing the results from lengthy and difficult discussions and deliberations from our judges' panels. We had scores, we had judges submitted scores, and judges submitted comments, and judges commented on online live during the previous broadcast for the first tier. And then all of that had to be put together to finally be able to name the selected artists who will be going to New York to perform on November 21st. But that's at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard tonight.
And after that, you and I and our team will pass out.
Yes, we will. I said that
since we started at 8 a.m. and go to like probably, close to 11 p.m.
No, we didn't. We started at 6 a.m.
Oh, yeah, that's right. And yeah, that's you and the crew started a little before me. Definitely.
Okay, and for now, we just to take a short break and join us on the next broadcast. Thank you all very much. Broadcasting from Virginia, Washington, D.C. suburb, and from upstate New York, Fredonia, and from all over around the globe.